Today, we repair a broken pan handle by cutting 3D pockets with the K40 laser cutter. The handle of this pan is broken. I already glued it back in place with epoxy once, but it broke again and now needs a more permanent repair. The raclette pan will get a fair bit of heat, the material should survive the dishwasher, and it should be easy to produce a few more handles when the other pans start to fail. The first thing that comes to mind is to use 3D printing, which would be the easiest way to mass produce pan handles. However, while PETG might survive the dishwasher, it will get soft at around 70 degrees, which is not ideal for a pan. Wood would be a good alternative as it looks nice and I could create handles on the CNC. It is reasonably temperature resistant, but it will fail in the dishwasher. Brass or aluminum would be a nice alternative, but my CNC will not cut them well and it would be quite expensive for a few cheap pans. This brought me to acrylic. The material begins to soften at 150 degrees Celsius, will survive the dishwasher, and I have been cutting acrylic on the laser in the past. Now let's see how to cut a recess in the material. The design for the handle is quickly modeled in FreeCAD. It's basically a rectangle with two pockets for the handle part and two holes to secure the handle to the pan. After exporting the DXF, we used LibreCut to convert the DXF to SVG and open the SVG in Inkscape. As FreeCAD is exporting all lines in the 3D space, in our case the border on the top and the bottom, we removed the duplicated lines and used the Node Edit tool to combine them into a single shape. While we are in Inkscape, let's prepare a simple test piece to test the depth of the engraving. We create four squares that we will engrave later with different speeds. After engraving the text, we change the color of all but one square. I have marked a few power settings on the laser so that I can set them repeatedly at 5 milliamps. In the K40 Whisperer software, we load the design and engrave only one square at the selected speed. After the laser has finished, we mark the second square black and repeat the process till all four squares are cut. We then measure the depth of each square with a caliper. The speed at the first square was too slow as it cut all the way through the material. In LibreOffice, we put the speeds and the depth at each speed in a table and run a linear regression. The line goes reasonably well through all the three points and with a little math, we can calculate the required speed for a certain depth. On my website, I will provide you with a simplified version of the spreadsheet that you can use with your own values and that does all the math for you. For the pan handle, we set the engraving speed to the one we just calculated and then run the engraving and cut the exterior shape as well as the holes. The fit is not perfect out of the laser as I was staying on the conservative side and wanted to rather remove too little than too much of material. Shaping acrylic with a file is no big deal. With a little bit of filing, the handle fits perfectly between the two layers of acrylic. The metal part is glued to the acrylic with a bit of epoxy. For gluing the surfaces together, I use a special acrylic glue that creates a chemical reaction welding the two surfaces into one piece. With the pre-cut holes as a guide, I bore two 1.5mm holes through both layers of acrylic. Afterwards, the holes get a small counterbore. As a last step, I want to secure the handle through the holes. Usually I would use a nail for this kind of pinning. As a nail would rust in the dishwasher, I use a thin brass rod and then hammer it from both sides flat. This will secure the pin mechanically in the holes. The sides get a quick sanding as they slipped a bit during the glue up. I could polish the edges, but realistically, the high gloss finish is not going to survive the everyday abuse, so let's call this project done. I am very happy with the process of cutting a recess into material on the laser. It creates sharp corners and is for small items much more precise than a CNC. Don't forget to subscribe and have a look at the playlist with more laser cutting projects.